qualities and generous atmosphere of charm. Signed, Laurence Olivier. If I could sum up in just 5 words this lovely little theatre, I suppose I could call it a national and international theatre star. This is the oldest theatre in Australia. It's been operating now for 169 years, and who knows, it might still be here in another 169 years.
Salamanca has no specific reference to Tasmania. It actually comes from one of the battles in the Napoleonic Wars, the Battle of Salamanca off the west coast of Spain, I think it was, and some of the descendants of that battle came to settle in Tasmania, and they just sort of enshrined the name.
West Africa.
Oh, we're from China. Yeah.
We're from Victoria, from Hillsville.
Oh no, we're not local. No, we're from South Sydney.
And we have a great time here.
I've bought some silver beads, which I'm going to cook in an African style.
We've just picked up your standard stubby holder, which always comes in handy. You cannot have enough of stubby holders.
Oh, it's a lovely little motorcycle out of nuts and bolts for grandson Jason.
We buy some honey, yeah, some...
You can find so many local stuff here.
Yeah, it's a nice place.
Yeah, Salamanca Place is a great spot for the markets, right in the heart of historic Hobart. Now, the Rest Point Casino was Australia's first legal casino. Opened in 1973, the casino was the start of a booming national casino industry. It's a landmark in Hobart and is still the city's tallest building.
Gambling is what it's all about. Down the chutes go $50,000 between 2 p.m. and 3 the following morning, 7 days a week, and most of it from the pockets of Tasmanians. Casino facilities designed for 300 people are already overstretched, and it's frequently impossible to get a game on any of the 19 tables. Already, this casino is grossing more than the London Playboy Club. 110 croupiers and dealers work a roster system for about $90 a week. Tipping, unlike most casinos, is not allowed. But if it hadn't been for a referendum in 1968, they might never have had these jobs at all.
I felt that gambling facilities of this nature were not wholly in the interest of the people of Tasmania. And therefore, I and a great many other people, I think, in this state, initially opposed the establishment of a casino. But, of course, as you know, there was a referendum held on the matter, and the people decided that there should be a casino, and we, as a responsible political party, felt we should abide by the wishes of the people expressed at the referendum.
2 years ago, the government estimated casino tax could return them about $60,000 a year. They now expect $1 million. Tasmanian Labor Premier Mr. Eric Rees.
It was only because of a defection, if I can put it in those terms, of a Liberal member, that the bill ultimately was approved by the House of Assembly. But the thing that really carried it through in both Houses of Parliament was the proposal for a referendum of the people as to whether there ought to be a casino or not. And the referendum bill was passed by both Houses, and the people did agree to it by a fairly substantial majority.
Can they afford to continue gambling at the rate they are at present?
Well, this is a question that only individuals can answer. They are doing this, and they're enjoying it.
Are you concerned about it?
Well, I go down and have a game myself occasionally. And I'm not concerned about what I do.